us go through it, right? All of us at some point in time feel, and the reason I didn't try to take that decision that this is what I want to do, I mean, everybody around just says, you know, like I remember when I wanted to start Kidsstoppress, everybody said, are you serious? Want to start something when you're at the peak of your career? And I was like,
something that seems more risky, right?
Exactly, absolutely. Moving on, Payal, why children? Why both for children?
Children, I didn't instinctively start out saying I wanted to write for children, but I do remember that my own love for books started as a child. I remember haunting all the libraries in my area. I remember the library was haunting my mother, that I was using way too much money and spending way too much and coming back every day for a fresh batch of books. So, you know, my own love for reading, my own love for writing started as a child. I also credit a lot of that to my English because at school, and I had a wonderful spectrum of reading. I grew up reading even lighter.
Right.
I was introduced to Roald Dahl a little later. But when we were growing up, I don't think there was the kind of wide gamut of children's fiction that you see today.
Right.
So when I started reviewing books and I came across Eden Golfer and then I came across Eden Funk, and I said, wow, there's such fantastic writing out there. And some of, I mean, a lot of those ideas in my
life.
And also when I started writing, I had just become a mother and I was going back to being a child and looking at the world that way again. So I think it all came together and then it was perfectly natural.